Before we talk about black holes, I have an exciting announcement. We are now selling Life's Biggest Questions merchandise. We have two awesome t-shirts at the moment, and I'm going to leave the link to them in the description box down below. You can get these exclusive items right now before the holidays, and they're available for a limited time only, so hurry, hurry. Okay, black holes. Black holes fill me with dread, but probably only because there is so much mystery surrounding them. Should we be scared of them? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what is on the other side of a black hole? You guys seem to enjoy our what would happen if Earth was sucked into a black hole video so much that we thought we would delve deeper and decipher part of this mystery for you. Despite the mystery surrounding black holes, it is estimated that there are as many as 10 million, or maybe even more, in our galaxy, the Milky Way, alone. There are two types of black hole that we know of: supermassive black holes, which are at the heart of every galaxy, and stellar mass black holes. Supermassive black holes have the mass of millions of stars, and stellar mass black holes are still dense, but on a much smaller scale, and they can move. We don't really know how supermassive black holes formed, but we do have some insight into stellar masses. The stellar mass black hole comes from the gravitational collapse of huge stars. Our sun, for example, would not be big enough to form a black hole. When stars, roughly 25 times the size of our sun, reach their end of life phase, they become supernovas, exploding outwards, but also imploding inwards, buckling under their own mass. Hole is perhaps not the right word for a black hole, because they aren't exactly empty. They're actually very, very dense. So dense, their gravity is so strong that they start drawing in other matter around them, and not even light can escape them. Time and space buckle around black holes, and the laws of physics as we know them start to break down. So what happens inside one, or what's at the bottom of one, or is there even another side? The true answer is, we don't exactly know, but there are some key theories. As I said, black holes are dense. What's inside a black hole is the collapsed matter of the star, and in theory, this collapse goes on and on and on until things get thinner and thinner and denser, leading to a point of singularity. This is one theory anyway, and possibly the most credible. However, there are a number of theories as to what goes on beyond the event horizon, the moment something starts getting deconstructed by a black hole. The theory of loop quantum gravity suggests that there is no singularity, but black holes are simply folds in the universe. Everything we know about quantum physics tells us that information is never lost, that energy can't be created or destroyed. So perhaps black holes are folds or portals to older universes. We're gonna get very deep for a second, so hold on to your hats. Our main theory about the formation of the universe is that it came from one hot, dense point of singularity that expanded outwards, the Big Bang, if you will. The formation of the universe seems like the opposite of a black hole, which sucks in and deconstructs matter into a smaller and smaller amount of space-time. Perhaps the point of singularity in a black hole, the end point, if you will, is the starting point of another universe. This is pretty much what is discussed in the Big Bounce theory. So these are stellar mass black holes, the easiest type of black hole to study, as we cannot get anywhere near a supermassive black hole. There may be another type of black hole too. According to a NASA Q&A page, mathematicians and physicists have theorized that there are hollow black holes that don't require the collapse of a star to form. This type of black hole is imagined to have an exotic geometry and be a place where time travel is possible. Well, blimey, NASA, careful where you're spilling that huge can of worms. But of course, before we all get too excited, we should remember that time travel will only be possible if we're ever able to manage to move faster than the speed of light, which of course right now we're very much unable to do, but maybe one day. There is one more interesting thing to say about black holes, and that is they tend to leave ghosts behind them. By that I mean, as Stephen Hawking observed, the information contained in matter that falls into a black hole seems to be copied and frozen around the event horizon. As NASA puts it, this raises some interesting possibilities that we could resurrect clocks, humans, spacecraft, and whole planets into something like their pristine form if we could magically reverse the infall and collapse process. Whew, well, I think that is enough for one day. Fundamentally, the short answer is, we don't know what exactly is on the other side of a black hole, but we have some good theories. We suspect it's infinitely dense, and some suspect it could be a portal to a new dimension. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. For now, I'm Rebecca Felgate. Don't forget to check out our merch, and of course, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning. If you want to continue your questioning binge, why not check out our biggest science questions and our biggest what ifs?